Dotfor just leaked the secret formula on how to get an amazing CRT effect. And in this video, I will show you how to do it in Premiere Pro. So first, we need to add some blur to the video. So go to Effects and search Gaussian Blur. And then apply the blur effect to the video. Now go to Effects Controls and set the blurriness to around 8. And this will add a really subtle blur to the video. For the next effect, we're going to create these small vertical lines. So go to the Effects panel and search Grid. And then apply the grid effect to the video. Now in effects controls, scroll all the way down and change the corner Y position value so these lines are out of the screen. And to remove the center line, we need to change the anchor values. Now change the first corner value so we get these lines. And I found that 966 works really good. And then set the blend mode to overlay. We have now this TV look. And you can see it more clearly if you zoom in a bit. And if you want, you can also change the border value to make these lines thicker or smaller. Now to add this curvature to the video, we need to go to effects and search lens distortion and apply the effect to the video. Then go to effects controls and set the curvature to around 11. And this will apply a curvature to our video. And to remove this white background, we simply need to scroll all the way to the top and then scale up the video a bit. For the next step, we need to open the Lumetri Color tab. And if you don't have it, then go to Window and click on Lumetri Color. Now expand the basic correction and then increase the exposure to around 0.7. And also increase the contrast to about 75. And here is the before and after. And to add a vignette to the video, we can expand vignette and then set the amount to negative 0.7 or whatever you like. And this will add its black look around the corners. To make this glitch color look, we need to go to effects panel and search chromatic aberration and then apply the effect to our video clip. And in effects controls, check fall off invert so the effect only happens on the edges. And also set the fall off distance to 0. And this will give us a really subtle chromatic aberration effect. For the next step, we're going to need an adjustment layer. So open the project panel, click on new item and select adjustment layer and click on OK. Now drag the adjustment layer above your video in the timeline. Then go to effects and search Gaussian blur and apply the effect to the adjustment layer. And then in effects controls, set the blurriness to around 7. And then click on the circle under Gaussian blur to create the circular mask. And then create this oval shape using these blue handles. And then click on inverted in effects controls. And this will blur the edges of the screen. But as you might see, the edges are a bit sharp. So to fix this, you can simply increase the mask feather value a bit. And if you turn on and off the effect, you can see the slight edge blur on the video. Now to really make this look like a TV, we need to go to effects and search strobe light. And then apply the strobe light effect through adjustment layer. And in effects controls, set the blend with original value to 98. And then set the strobe duration to 0.01. And the strobe period to 0.02. And if you want, you can also change the random strobe probability to a random value. And this will give us a really subtle light flick effect. And if you want the effect to be less intense, then you can choose a higher blend with original value. Now on top of this, we are going to add this grain overlay. So drag it above all the other layers. And in effects controls, set the blend mode to overlay. And last but not least, we are going to add some camera shake. So go to effects and search camera shake. Then apply the shake to the adjustment layer. And this is the final effect. Subscribe.